Hello and welcome to our project documentary video. Myself Jigar Suresh Bhai Pisavadia and with my project partner Amit Rawat. The students of LD College of Engineering from Instrumentation and Control Department. We had done a final year project on the topic Industrial Effluent Discharging and Monitoring System.
In our project, basically, we are trying to monitor the waste or effluents discharging from industries and to provide those data to government so that we can keep an eye on the waste or effluents discharging from industries and punish or penalize them or those small-scale industries or those persons who illegally done smelting of iron. When they cross certain limit as decided by PCB, which is none other than Pollution Control Board. Basically, our aim is to cover the industry ranging from small scale to large scale industry so that government get adequate data and take necessary control action. In our project, we have used two sensors, which are MQ2 gas sensor and the other DS18B20 temperature sensor. MQ2 gas sensor can detect hydrogen gas, carbon monoxide gas, LPG, smoke, alcohol, propane and methane. Beside MQ2 gas sensor, there are other series of MQ series which help us to detect various other gases. And it can detect concentration of a gas ranging anywhere from 200 to 10,000 ppm. And its operating voltage is 5 volt. It has sensitive tin dioxide material, whose conductivity increase with increase in gas concentration. MQ2 gas sensor, which is has 4 pin. The first one is VCC, which we normally use to give supply to the sensor. The other one is the ground, which is normally used to ground that sensor. And third is the D0, which is the digital output pin. And fourth is the A0, which is the analog output pin. And correspondingly, we use DS18B20. Temperature sensor to measure the temperature of the slurries or effluent discharging from industry, because indirectly it affects the fertility of the soil. Because as we know in chemistry that temperature act as a catalyst, because if it's a high temperature, it's supportive to reaction. So there are certain norms decided by the government that the temperature of the slurry should not exceed 50 degrees Celsius.
So here, as you can see, the given in the table 1, the example of refuse, cement and concrete. So according to the standards, the given compound listed here must not exceed the certain ranges. So if these ranges are being violated by any industries, the government has the right to stop and takes necessary control actions. Now moving to the working model. Here we have developed a little prototype of the industry where you can see a chimney located above it with gas sensor, also a local LCD display for local monitoring, a buzzer for alerting about the violations of the standards decided by the government. We have also mounted a Wi-Fi for transmitting this data to the local authorities. The Wi-Fi module has been installed with the IP address of the government websites where they can continuously watch and can be recorded and can be viewed as a daily basis, weekly basis or monthly basis. So here the display displays the temperature and the gas effluent that is in ppm. Here the temperature is at the room temperature, so it is around 39 to 40 degrees Celsius. For gas sensor, we have programmed its limit to 250 ppm, and when this effluent crosses 250 ppm, this solenoid valve with the help of relay logic gets actuated and trips the process so that to reduce the pollution in the air. Now for the gas sensor, we have used a DO which usually contains the alcohol content, and we have calibrated our gas sensors according to it. Now once the gas sensor crosses to 250 ppm of effluent, the display shows the gas is detected, see, as you can see, and correspondingly it can be seen in the
carbon panel also, which can be viewed in trend form and pointer scale, as you can see.